Hey, what's up? This is Dr. Taylor Crick at the Washington Wellness Center, and I want to share a study that came across my email recently. It's called Gut Permeability and Depressive Symptom Severity in Unmedicated Adolescents. So they took these teens, okay, unmedicated teens, healthy teens. I think they're all girls, and they just, so they're unmedicated, they don't have any complaints, and they had them do a depression survey. And then they also had them do a leaky gut test, and they correlated the results of how depressed were they correlated with how leaky was their gut. And here are the highlights. In unmedicated adolescents, depression severity was associated with increased intestinal permeability. So the more depressed they were, the more leaky their gut was. There was a positive correlation. They said increased leaky gut may mediate the association between sympathetic nervous system activation and depression severity. So what that means is that leaky gut is kind of the gateway in linking the stress response to how depressed teens are. And then the last thing it says, our preliminary evidence suggests that increased intestinal permeability may activate the innate immune system, promoting the development of depression, meaning it may lead to inflammation that promotes depression. So what's the relevance of this? Well, you know, in today's society with our teens and with anxiety and depression, it's just rampant. And I think that so often we think of like, you know, do they need to go on a medication or what could be causing this psychologically? But what this paper is showing from the Journal of Affective Disorders in 2019 is showing that leaky gut can lead to inflammation, and together with the stress response, activated the stress response, can lead to depression. And that's really the leading theory of depression today, is that it's not caused by neurotransmitter imbalance, it's actually caused by inflammation. So that's something that most parents probably aren't thinking of. If their kids are a little bit depressed, if they have ADHD, if they have anxiety, if they have neurological issues, there could be a gut component, and where there's a problem, there's often a solution, and the cause is often also going to be the solution. So that's what we do at our office, is try to figure out some things like that.